The Formula One circus has made its way to the southern coast of Portugal this week, and it's preparing for what I expect to be a terrific race here in Portimão. ...2.9 miles of track at Portimão, featuring 15 turns, 9 to the right and 6 to the left. There's a lot going on here, a lot of elevation changes that will affect the driver's braking and acceleration. Keep an eye out for the DRS zone on the final straight. That will be the setup for a lot of today's overtaking chances. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious. As a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Perez, Charles Leclerc and Sainz, Norris, Ricciardo, Gasly, the owner driver, Tsunoda, Fernando Alonso, Lance Stroll and Ocon, Giovinazzi, Russell, Kimi Raikkonen and Mick Schumacher, Armstrong, Latifi, Vettel. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, and Nikita Mazepin. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going. Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. No rain expected for the time being. rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. safety gap to the car ahead is 2.6 seconds. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Green flag. Some information on Alonso. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car. Caution. Be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. The car behind us is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. We expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. to car in front is 5.9 seconds. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the hards. Okay, gap ahead is 12.4 seconds. Release. Look after these tires now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Marcus is in the pits. Marcus in the pits. Pace is strong, but be aware your tyres need to go the distance. We're leading our teammate by 22.8 seconds. Gap to the car in front is 11.0 seconds. The gap to the car ahead is 13.2 seconds. Gap to teammate behind is 29.1 seconds. Marcus is out of the race. Yellow flag. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. Green flag. Gap to car in front is 4.3 seconds. Okay, gap ahead is 17.2 seconds. Gap to the car in front is 1.5 seconds. Okay, you're catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres. lost some time to the car behind. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. The gap to the car ahead is 1.9 seconds. For now, keep taking care of them. We're starting to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop. Gap to car in front is 3.0 seconds. We have a gap of about 3 seconds between you and the next car. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. You're dropping a second a lap to the car behind. 1 second. gap ahead is 5.4 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Victory for the team from Milton Keynes then, after a quality performance. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Red Bull put up an outstanding fight for the front position today, and it's great to see it paid off for them. They do so much for the sport that you can't help but be delighted by today's race win. Let's have a look then at the drivers' standings. Max Verstappen now leads the Drivers' Championship. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
Sebastian Vettel would definitely be my first choice. He showed up a lot of the drivers out on the track today and didn't show any signs of slowing down.
Let's move on to the constructors. Red Bull take over as championship leaders. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that.
Your team must be ecstatic with how you're performing.
It looks like you've invested heavily in the development of new parts. Appreciate your time.